Now let's examine the directory structure for the PyData Archive. In general, there are two folder locations that contain all Py-related components. They are Py and PyPC. The Py folder contains all components related to the PyData Archive, whereas PyPC folder contains all client-side tools such as PySMT, which stands for Py System Management Tool, PySDK, to name a few. Pertaining to the PyData Archive components, some important folder contents to note are ADM, which contains all the administrative utilities, such as utilities to start and stop your PyData Archive. Bin folder contains all your binaries. DAT folder is a very important folder. This contains all components that uniquely identifies your PyData Archive, such as trust table and so on. It is also worth noting that by default, this acts as a location where the queue files as well as archive files would reside, unless otherwise you explicitly mention a different location. And finally, log folder, which contains all the log files associated with your PyData Archive. If you need to access the PyData Archive related components from a command prompt, you can utilize the environmental variable called PyServer. To demonstrate, if I go to my PyPy command prompt and type in cd space PyServer percent, it is going to automatically navigate me to the location where the PyData Archive is installed. From here, I can go to the subfolder, such as ADM, if I want to start and stop my PyData Archive, etc. As we mentioned earlier, the PyDAT folder is usually the default location where even queue files and archive files would reside. But during installation of the PyData Archive, you can specify a directory for hosting the archive files and even queue files. As a matter of fact, we recommend placing the archive files, even queue files, and even the PyData Archive backup files on separate drives as shown. Currently, our archives reside under C, Py, Arc. It is worth noting that currently we have only one archive registered with the PyData Archive, and each archive has two set of files. One is the archive file and another one is the associated annotation file. Though in the current installation, the archives are installed in the same drive as the PyData Archive components, it is strongly recommended that the archives be installed on separate drives. As a matter of fact, we will go through the procedure of moving the archives to a new directory in the D drive shortly. Finally, if you need to access the PyPC folder location from a command prompt, you can again utilize the environmental variable, and this one is PyHome. If you want to navigate to the 32-bit PyPC folder that contains all 32-bit client-side applications, or I can go to PyHome64 to get to the 64-bit PyPC folder location that contains all 64-bit client-side application. To demonstrate, if I go to the command prompt and type in cd space percent PyHome percent, it will take me to the 32-bit PyPC folder location. Likewise, if I say cd space percent PyHome64 percent, it will take me to the 64-bit PyPC folder location.